Well, let's move to engagement then. So we've kind of followed this pattern.
Yep, following that track.
Why engagement?
Because it is, I'm interested always in whether we can impact thinking, right? Mm-hmm. Can you really impact my thinking? Well, we know that's true, because if you say to do something, I just do it. But
that's compliance.
That's compliance. That's right. But I was fascinated by comprehension strategies because I was intrigued by the notion that you could actually improve someone's comprehension. Mm-hmm. Right? I came from the era in my own schooling where you either got it or you didn't get it. Mm-hmm. But here someone was saying we can intervene in order to improve mm-hmm. comprehension. So the same thing is now true for engagement. It follows logically. If we know what it takes to facilitate comprehension, strategies help. If we know what deeper understanding is, if we know how to facilitate dialogue around deeper understanding, then the next logical notion for me is, is it possible to teach kids to self-engage? Mm-hmm. Because now I think we have a lot of us, and I was one of them, running around trying to keep kids entertained and trying to keep kids motivated. And, you know, it sort of becomes a show, doesn't it? And it's all on the teacher. My interest is, can a child learn what engagement looks like, get intoxicated by it, mm-hmm. get to the point where they feel like, I want to feel that again, mm-hmm. and choose to re-engage when they aren't engaged. And I'm interested in pushing the definition of engagement beyond where I think it's gone so far. I'm interested in a broader definition of engagement than I think we've seen so far.
What broader in what way? Why are we limited?
I think we're limited in education literature. I think we've been limited in thinking of engagement as kids are doing what they're supposed to be doing. They're answering questions. They're turning in their papers on time.
They're on task.
Yeah, they're on task. I think on task are the two words I care for least in the English language. Mm. They can be very much on task and completely disengaged. And I remember that very clearly as a kid. Mm-hmm. And I think most people probably do. So what is real engagement? And I'm going to argue in this book that engagement has several dimensions, and that we can't, of course, have all of those dimensions all of the time. You wouldn't want to be truly and deeply engaged all the time. The brain needs breaks. But the more kids understand about those dimensions, the more we model engagement for them and talk about how it actually feels to be deeply engaged, the more they are going to be able to do that for themselves. But I don't think that's just classroom work, nor do I think it's, the traditional notions of engagement always, being in a context of a book or an engaging science experiment. Engagement happens for kids, sadly, mostly outside of school. So what I want to do is understand what engagement looks like outside of the school, and then learn what we can from times when kids are spontaneously engaged in play or in, other things that they're doing outside of school, and say, okay, what does that mean for us in the classroom? Mm-hmm. And can we, in a sense, teach engagement? That's mm-hmm. what I'm fascinated by now. I always write off a question and really, as you know, very rarely have answers.
It's a good question. Sometimes when I have a student who's like a runner or an actor, I want to watch them run or act.
Yeah.
And my reaction is always the same. I think, could you give me 20% of that? If you could give me 20% of that,
right,
I could make you the best.
Yeah, yeah.
And this is like often extracurricular, taught by a volunteer coach or,
Exactly.
And I'm a professor, but yeah. I want some of that.
Some of that, exactly. Yeah. And that's what I want kids to feel. I want some of that.
Yeah.
Just if my teacher is modeling his or her excitement about something, the complete loss of the sense of self in the present to an experience that's either active or cognitively active, yeah, that sense that you feel like time doesn't have any meaning and you slip away,
yeah,
if a kid can understand that from dialogue with an adult and then experience that,
yeah.
My hypothesis is that children will then choose to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And that puts teachers in a very different role because we're no longer responsible for motivating our kids, for doing something to get them excited. Rather, they've learned how to get themselves excited about learning.